Yo, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. We're back with another one, man. Another Nike dunk, bro. I told you, 2021 Nike's coming with dunks out the wazoo, bro. And we copping. Yeah. All right, let me get into the box real quick. Standard Nike box. Red with the white lettering. As you can see, it's a tiny box. It's a size 6.5 women's. It's a Nike Dunk Low. The colorway is Sail and Orange Pearl. Let's get right into it, man. These are gonna be pretty hard to see on camera. It is a really light colorway. It's white and a light pink. So you're not gonna see them too well on our camera besides the B-roll, but let's get into it, man. And these joints are clean, boy. First impression, I mean, these are honestly, they're a nice women's shoe. Obviously, we're going to see some dudes, you know, out here trying to swag them out too, but these are really dope women's shoes. So really nice, light, kind of pastel color. It's like a nudish pink. The pink isn't really too pronounced, which I like. This gives it a lot of options as far as what you can rock it with. The pink doesn't, you know, pop out too much, so it's a pretty neutral colorway. I like it, man. I mean, I know the girls are going crazy for them already. Resale's already hitting for 300 plus, and I think it's just gonna be up from there. So if you're trying to cop, I would recommend copping ASAP because the prices on these are gonna get pretty crazy, man. This is just a super clean dunk, classic color blocking. Like I said, hard to see on camera, but you got your classic dunk color blocking. The quality feels pretty decent on these, man. It feels a lot better than the dunk highs that I just reviewed in my last video. The leather on those was pretty stiff. Like, it felt kind of plasticky. These have some more give to it. It feels a little more plush as far as the leather goes, which I do prefer when it comes to you know, my dunks. I like that kind of plush leather. That usually makes for just a better worn in look over time, opposed to like the plasticky just kind of creases in a harsher manner. But yeah, these are really clean, man. I mean, no complaints on my end. The shoe that it reminds me most of is the Crimson Tint Jordan 1s. Those obviously have the black to contrast the pink a little bit better, but that pink colorway is pretty much, the pink color blocking is pretty much the same. Yeah, that pink color is pretty much the same as we see on the Crimson Tints here. Same thing, that color is so light, it's kind of hard to see on camera. Color comparison, it's pretty much the same. So if you've had the Crimson Tints or seen those, that's pretty much the color that you're working with on these dunks here. See, like when I hold them up here, you can't see nada, Nathan, bro. But yeah, super dope, man. I mean, I didn't need them for my personal collection. Like I said, I mean, just looks a little feminine for my taste. Can't go wrong with the Nike Dunk Low. It's definitely gonna be the shoe of the summer. Nike Dunk Lows, we're gonna see them all summer 21, guaranteed. I think it would have definitely been the shoe of last summer, but we were inside, you know, everybody was kind of locked down, so no one was stunned like they really wanted to. So I think this summer is gonna be, it's gonna be active, bro. Outside is gonna be popping this summer, so you're gonna see a lot of Nike Dunks out here, guaranteed. and these are gonna be hitting. If you did watch last video, like I said, you know, shoes like this that I don't keep for the personal, a lot of time obviously I sell them for profit or I'll hold them for trade bait. So, you know, a shoe like this, I'm gonna hold on to it. Once it's worth about $400 or so, I use it to, you know, trade for something that I do want, or sell and use that money to, you know, get something that I actually do want in the personal collection. You know, in my personal experience, it's been the smartest way to go about, you know, copping exclusive sneakers for a lower price point, because obviously, rather than me just coming out of pocket $400, I spent $100 on these. I'm gonna sell them off and I'll be able to get, you know, something I actually want without spending any crazy amounts. 2021, man, to be a sneakerhead, you almost have to be a reseller, bro. You have to be conscious of what things are going for, what they're worth, you know, quantities in terms of, you know, stock and everything like that. You got to be aware of everything, you know, that the resellers are aware of if you want to be able to cop anything. So you got to think like a reseller in 2021, man, if you want to cop shoes. That's just how it is. Hate to say it, but it is what it is, man. You're either going to complain or you're going to adapt. So I'm trying to help y'all adapt, bro. You gotta adapt. Like I said, you just got to go for everything, you know. Enter every Nike draw, even if it's a shoe you don't necessarily like. I know a lot of people, you know, they skipped out on those ready-made Blazers. Not your cup of tea. I get it. That's, you know, personally not my thing either. But they're reselling, so you gotta go for things like that anyway, bro. You just got to. Just go for it. And the way the Nike sneakers works, bro, you're gonna hit on the shoes that you don't want. It happens to me all the time. Like, the shoes that I don't care about, the shoes that I don't really care for personally, those are the ones that, you know, I get that got them for. So, case in point, bro. Wasn't thinking about it. The got them came up. Pleasant surprise. But now I got a nice shoe that's gonna be trade bait, something that I want, because Lord knows I'm gonna miss out on something that I really want in the next couple of weeks, months, whatever it is. You know, we got things like those UNC4s coming out. What else is coming out? Like my Air Max Bacon's coming out. You know, things like that that I actually do want, I keep in the back of my mind. So it's like, yo, if I don't hit, all right, I got this shoe I can sell, boom. Now I get that shoe for what? Pretty much the same thing as, you know, getting it for resale. So small finesse, but big savings in the end. But that's all I got for y'all today, man. Let me know what you guys think of these dunks in the comment down below. Drop a comment, drop a like, subscribe to the channel. You know, I got some more fire on the way. We're gonna be copping fire kicks all 2021. No Arby's, we got the heats. It's gonna be the new slogan for real, man. But stay tuned, we got a lot more coming for y'all. Peace.